timeline window in SEGGER's Ozone Debugger is able to correlate and visualize data sampling, current consumption, and program execution in one combined signal plot. The timeline's data pane displays the graphs of sampled variables and expressions. The power pane displays the target's power consumption. The code pane displays the visual representation of the program's call stack generated from trace program execution. All panes in the timeline window share a common timescale. This enables users to compare the target's power consumption against code execution or to observe the state of selected data at a particular point in program execution. To see this in action, we can use the SEGGER Ozone Debugger, a SEGGER JTrace Pro, plus a target board that is suitable to be powered by JTrace Pro, such as one of SEGGER's Trace reference boards. The target device needs to have the embedded trace macrocell ETM or program trace macrocell PTM, plus the associated trace data and trace clock pins. Note that you can also connect to the JTrace Pro via Gigabit Ethernet. As a software project, we can use the Ozone JTrace Pro tutorial project from the SEGGER website. The project creates two emboss RTOS tasks that toggle two LEDs at different intervals. After downloading and running the project, we can graph the values of two global variables, count 1 and count 2, in the data pane. We can also see the current consumption of the board in the power pane. The current consumption varies depending on how many LEDs are turned on at any given time. After we halt the program execution, the code pane in the timeline window gets updated. We can zoom into the timeline and see how the change in current consumption correlates with the task switches in the code. Whenever one of the two tasks turns an LED on or off, the current jumps or drops by about 6 milliamps shortly afterwards. Zooming even closer into the details of the task switch shows how the emboss RTOS switches from the idle task to one of the two tasks toggling the LEDs, and then switches back to the idle task. Observe changes in current by about 12 milliamps are caused by both tasks being executed back to back and both turning their respective LEDs on or off. In this case, we see three task switches happening, from the idle task to the higher priority task, then to the lower priority task, and then back to the idle task. Interesting to note is that the selected row in the power sampling window is synchronized with the sample cursor of the timeline window. Please also note Ozone's capability to display the complete instruction trace history, as well as live code coverage and live code profiling information. You can also use the Ozone timeline window with a SEGGER J-Link without instruction trace. However, in this case, only the data pane and the power pane will be populated. This video introduced you to the timeline window in SEGGER's Ozone Debugger, which allows you to correlate and visualize data sampling, current consumption, and program execution in one combined signal plot. To learn more about Ozone, JTrace Pro, or any of our other hardware or software products, please visit www.segger.com. Thanks for watching!